Michelle must first assemble her crew.
Any experiment needs a really good team and lots of brains so that we can get a really good experiment going. First up, I'm teaming up with Tom the Blowfish Herd. He is the heavy metal marine biologist and the only one that I know of that's been crazy enough to play music to white sharks.
Tom Herd is an underwater acoustics expert who has been studying sharks for decades.
When it comes to sharks and acoustics, heavy metal is the perfect mix. I mean, for starters, sharks have got great taste. But aside from that, the actual noises are very, very common in heavy metal, that drrr, 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 that you get on a drum beat or a bass line are very, very similar to the distress noises that we'd hear from, say, a big fish wagging its tail, going drrr, drrr. So they kind of go hand in hand.
And then, of course, if you come to Mossel Bay, the person to work with is Dr. Enrico Gennari. Great collaborator, brilliant white shark researcher and expert.
When I was 5 years old, I told my mom I would become a shark researcher in South Africa. Okay, here I am, camera in front, great white sharks all around. This is my dream coming through.
The team will begin their search at the great white's favorite feeding grounds. Seal Island, just 4 miles off the coast of South Africa. This rock is home to a large colony of seals. The white sharks have been known to hunt.
Everybody's here. This is the cafeteria for white sharks in this area.
Yeah, it's the table is laid. It's time to get the munch on.
And as soon as they arrive.
Oh my God! Oh! They should have reeled one! Guys, keep looking. Cameras on those areas.
They witnessed the first breach of the day.
First 10 minutes in the water, and we got a breach. This is a good sign.
Mossel Bay, South Africa is an area where white sharks are actively hunting, which means that they're actively breaching. So, we're gonna take our decoys out to the island and send the hydrophone out to the decoy.
Okay, we are hot to trot.
And then hopefully, when the shark smashes onto the surface of the water, we'll get a clear, crisp audio recording of that splash.
Let's rock and roll.
Okay, it's quite close.
Yeah, keep watching.
Talking about.
A juvenile great white attacks the seal decoy and launches into the air. The team reels in the decoy to assess the damage and see if they got a clean recording.
There we go. Let's see the bites.
First film.
Ooh, just a hit.
Yeah, a little bit.
The size of the bite mark left on the seal decoy allows the team to estimate the full size of the white shark.
But I think this was a very inexperienced young white shark.
Even though this is a smaller shark, we can tell by the size of this arch of the bite, it's still a seal. Yeah, it's a seal killer for sure.
Did you record? Were you recording?
Yeah, but I think the hydrophones come quite a bit of the way up.
Oh, yeah, that too.
You didn't get
it. Didn't get it.
Missed him.
Oh, that was a good smack as well. That was a beautiful smack.
You can't fake a breach. You can't fake that type of behavior. I gave it like a 6 out of 10.
What you're saying is it's time to go again.
Again? Yeah! I like that.
I need the 10 out of 10. I want the full out kaboom. I want that straight out. To the side, splash. So
okay, there's only one way to do it. Do it again.
Let's do it again.
After a quick adjustment to the mic.
Getting too many wires here, it's like Spaghetti Junction.
Yeah. Michelle and her team reset the decoy.
Okay, see you in the water.
And wait for another strike.
All right, here we go.
The sun is quite high now, so really we have a window to get the next breach.
Yeah. Running out of time.
White sharks retreat to deeper waters to rest during the hottest parts of the day. With the sun reaching its zenith, their window is shrinking.
The gulls are totally convinced. They are circling the seal, waiting for it to get ripped in half.
Despite the frenzy of activity,
when it comes back into the water, it's bashed the decoy far away.
Michelle has yet to record the audio needed for her experiment.
Here we go. Come on. This is it. Come on.
Stop here one sec.
Guys, look, 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 look!
A 2,200-pound male explodes out of the water, flying 10 feet out of the air, before angling his tail to crash his body back into the water.
Oh, that was a nice one. When they went back in,
perfect.
That was a full-on body slam.
Perfect. It's exactly what we were looking for.
Oh, you beauty.
This
there shark? You go. This is it.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
That's a nice one. Yeah, a little chunk out of it.
Based off the bite mark left on the seal, Michelle estimates the shark they recorded was roughly 14 feet long.
That is, I think, the best we could have done in one morning.
Oh, yeah,
oh, easily, totally. Easily. This is exactly why we came to Mossel Bay, right? We've just recorded the white shark breach. I am so excited. I can't believe we pulled that together. We've got our sound recorded, so now we just gotta take that back on land, download it, take a look, and see what characteristics we can find between the two.
Hells yeah.
I'm excited.
Fire up the engines.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's do it.